I had Tiffany on a couple weeks ago, and I told her, I said, you know, she's gotten hot over the last couple years. And when you get hot, you also get a lot of criticism and beef. And I said, like, I said, you, Kevin, like, Joe Coy, Lil Rel, I go, those are just, like, good people at the core. I said, they're just good people. I was like, and when they get all this, like, it just comes out of left field with the criticism. Like, it wasn't, like, enticed or they had it coming. And I'm like, Tiff, you just seem to rise above it. And you do too, Kev. Like, you just kind of, all right. You never feel like, oh, he's fucked. He's fucked now. And when I told Tiff, I was like, oh, he's fucked. That's it. It's over.
Oh, shit. Yeah. He stepped on him now. Yeah.
He went too far with that one.
Oh, man.
I always say, take a step back. We all have our moments as a comedian where we think somebody did us wrong or we have an issue with somebody. And sometimes it's in our own brain. I'll be the first to admit, I've had issue with comics and I go, and then I take a step and like, wait a minute, they didn't really do anything. That's just me and my feelings right now. But before you run to social media, I'm always like, you kind of are eliminating yourself working with that person in the near future. You don't know what's coming down the pike next. And like, you don't know if your name's coming up behind closed doors and all of a sudden you're upset with somebody and you go to social media and it gets... And every news outlet picks it up. I'm like, your name, you never know what's going on behind closed doors and your name is popping up. Should we use him? And then you just got scratched off.
Here's how I process it. Okay. I'm a mentally strong individual. So I don't get bothered. I don't get bothered easily. It takes a lot to get me bothered. Because like you said, at the core, I'm a good dude. I know I'm a good dude. So when that's compromised, for you to say anything about me or have an issue with me, it's going to be on you. I don't have issues. I don't do the drama. I don't do the beefs. That's just not me. I don't come for anybody because I think there's room for all of us. I think in this craft, there's room for all of us to be successful. Yes, there's different levels, but everybody's time will come when it's supposed to. I also realize that in the business of entertainment, there's a movie that's always on display. And it's one of the most watched movies in the world. And that movie is The Rise of an Individual, which is crazy supported. Oh my God, we love you, we love you, we love you, we love you. And as that individual reaches said plateau or point in their career, it's the decision where some go, I'm sick of that shit, right? Not because they really are. It could be a cool thing to say. It could be a fad or whatever. And then the movie turns, and it's about the fall. The movie's rates and views go up because people are now tuning in to see the fall. You got the rise and the fall. So if you know that that movie constantly gets played and you know that it exists, it's your job to avoid the fall. And the best way to avoid the fall is to not feed into it. You know, ultimately, I'm not going to make everybody happy. I'm not going to make everybody laugh. Some people are going to think I'm talented. Some people are not. That's called decision-making from individuals. You got a choice to make. And if you choose to support me, then go buy a ticket, come see a show, go see a movie, download my Laugh Out Loud network, watch something I produce. If you feel like you don't want to, then you don't have to do any of those things. It's that simple. So when people go the extra mile to display that and display that hate or anger towards you, that's not about me. That's about them.
You ain't lying.
That's not about you, me. That's got nothing to do with me. So when y'all see people, man, I'm so sick of this motherfucker. He ain't funny. Ain't been funny since. Wait, you just spent all that time to a guy that doesn't know you and that's never going to respond. That anger ain't about me. That's about you. That's how I process it.